So namaste once again, and hope we all would have our lunch properly. And now we are back to our discussion. And with all this discussion, we are looking at how to enable our students so that they can resolve their concerns within themselves. So with this process of induction program, we are enabling them that they look at these proposals within themselves and are able to resolve, not looking forward to piecemeal solutions, but to a holistic solution. So if we ask ourselves, each one of us aspires to be healthy. For the student also, are we able to see that each one of us doesn't want to waste any time due to bad health, due to illness? And this is one of the concerns which is there amongst these fresh joinees. Are you able to make that observation? You can put a yes or a no. So we are getting so many responses saying that yes, the students have these concerns within them. In fact, if any one of you would like to share any such incident where you came across some student who could put forth these as the concerns and you could suggest some kind of solutions, we would like to hear from you. Or what you could suggest. Ji Renu ma'am, you raised your hand. Renu Marthi ji.
Ha ma'am, namaste, good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Yeah, so the general problem, general concern the students is that they will be missing the test and all because of the ill health, and due to pandemic time also many people have faced this ill health. But that time we would be counseling them and mentoring them to take care of the health and be of the...
Okay. Renu ji, we are not able to hear you.
Can you hear me, ma'am?
Please.
Yeah. Good afternoon. Good afternoon to all. So regarding the health issues, as far as the students are concerned, the general experience what we'll be facing is that the students fell ill, and because of some various reasons. Okay, one of them could be the stress. One of them could be the immunity, less immunity. And such situations, we will be counseling the students to recover fast and give the enough moral strength and boost them to recover fast. And once they come out of the after recovery, then we'll try to help them out, saying that we are there with you to help you to progress. That's what is the general experiences that we have faced during this pandemic time, ma'am.
So let's see. With all this discussion, we know that as faculty, as mentors, we want them to overcome all their concerns, to resolve all their concerns, whatever concerns they have. Ji, nice. Chandrasekhar sir wants to say something regarding this.
Yes, madam. Actually, this has not exactly happened to my students, but it happened with my son of my cousin. So, can I elaborate on it, madam?
Ji, sir, we'll have quick elaboration from you.
Yeah, he was he completed his engineering, and he was very much disturbed that he could not get a proper placement. But he wanted to become a very successful person. That was his aspiration, was to be happy and to be healthy. But upon completion of his engineering program, he did not get a proper placement. So he was very much some sort of a rejected situation. Then he was telling me the institution where I was studying, they do not have this placement facility, this, that, all minus points, as if he is very much disturbed and almost gone to a state of a depression. Then I asked him, during when you studied, okay, fine, during your engineering, which subject you liked the most? Then he was referring that, okay, in addition to engineering, I like the management subjects also. So then I counseled him to, why don't you go for a management program, and then he was very much excited about it. And then he completed his management program from a reputed institution, according to him. But in the process, I just asked him one question, that no doubt the college plays a vital role in getting a placement. But honestly, let me tell you that whichever college you are studying or you will be studying in that, wherever they get good placements of the institutions where they study, they go directly. So these people are joining top companies, according to you. Now, do you mean to say that in the company, whichever company they are working, all are from top colleges and top students? I mean, from top college students? It is not so. Majority of them are not from the so-called top students. Then they are also excelling. Why, when they can do it, why you cannot do it? Don't compare with them. You compare it yourself, compete with yourself, that you have an interest in management program. So with that, he inclined and studies, and he did his management program. And now he is a very successful one. He was not even confident of earning a 10,000 rupees per month, but now he is earning 60,000 rupees per month in a span of just 2 years. And he is very happy now. So this was his aspiration was there. And this was the pressure was there for me regarding the placement. So with this, I could counsel him properly and make his career put his career in the right track. And he's very much happy. And my brother-in-laws and other relatives also, they felt very happy for the timely and right advice to him. And in fact, others also followed him that, okay, if it happens like this, there is option for us that no need to get disturbed. There is always alternate course of action and we should chalk up on it. And two of his younger brothers also, they succeeded in like this only. So I feel very happy that at the right time, I could be a supportive to him in bringing out in helping to meet his aspirations by dealing with the pressures what he felt particularly at the placement. So this is a very, very live example and real life situation which I faced, and I wish to share in this platform. And I thank Vanchana Madam for giving this opportunity to share this, that there is always a alternate course of action provided we come across with the how you deal with these things. So thank you so much, Madam.
Nice sharing, sir. In fact, we can see that when we have clarity within ourselves, we are able to guide, we are able to facilitate the other with that right understanding. So since our students are also coming to this new setting, they have this aspiration to be healthy, right? They are coming, their food habits might change now because they are in hostel and all that, the water and all these things, because they're shifting from one region to the other. Some of the issues which the students keep facing, these infections from new environment, some kind of communicable, non-communicable diseases, some issue related to tensions, inefficient usage of their time and all. So let us see how our understanding as a human being can help us in resolving these issues. How we as human beings can really look at this and realize our aspiration. So as a student right now, we are discussing all this. This is the sixth session of the induction program, where we are discussing all this as mentors to our students, right? So let us take this quick reflection from you. What do you think? You want to realize these aspirations within you or not? What do you think?
Can participants reply, please?
You can put your responses in the chat so that we can have some responses.
Gee. Many yeses, Didi.
Gee, very nice, very nice. Let's put up the reflection in the...
Participants are requested to respond to the reflection poll. Yes, no, cannot say.
While you are responding to this, maybe we'd like to hear from Harminder Kaurji. She wanted to share something. Harminder Kaurji.
Hello, yes. Am I audible?
Please.
Yes. That topic. Namaste. Firstly, namaste, ma'am, to you, and namaste to all the participants. I'll just take 1 minute to share an incident where one of our very bright students, Nitin Pal, his name is. He had lost a lot of time in the first semester that he joined due to typhoid. He's basically a very intelligent student. And out of the 3 months, he almost missed 2 months' classes. And in the third month, when he met me, he was very disturbed on this issue. How will I make up? I've missed so many tests. I've missed so much assignments. So I gave him, I explained to him that everything will be okay. I got in touch with him to some of the good students of the class who helped him with his assignments and other tests and all. And within a few weeks, he was able to get over it. And surprisingly, in the next semester, he got a university position. That's student Nitin Pal. So that is how he got out of his anxiety of losing time due to his illness and still making up with a very bright, excellent academic performance.
Thank you.
This is what I wish to share, ma'am. Thank you.
Nice sharing. In fact, we all can see that if we have more and more clarity within ourselves, we are able to guide our students, we are able to mentor them in the right way, because they are looking up to us every time. So let us look at the responses which you have been putting. So I do need to understand the whole program to ensure good health. All of us are agreeing to it. As a student, when we ask this question to the student, we can see that they also understand that these health issues are really bothersome for them. And this is a concern, especially when they come to the new city. So let's see how understanding a human being enables us to get that clarity for ourselves. Right? We have looked at human being. Since morning, we have been putting forth to our students. In session 4, we talked about this, that a human being is a coexistence of self and body. And the needs of the self and the needs of the body, they are different from each other. The needs of the body are temporary, required in limited amount, and can be fulfilled by physiochemical things. While the needs of the self are in continuity, they are qualitative, can be fulfilled by this right understanding and right feeling. Looking at the activities of the self are in continuation. But when we look at the body, any activity of the body, can you think of any activity of the body which is in continuation? So if you find any such activity, you can put that in chat. Any activity of the body. Okay, Seema Patel ma'am has raised the hand. You wanted to say something regarding any activity of the body which is in continuation, Seema ji? Could you think of some activity, Dr. Seema Patel ji? Any activity of the body?
Ma'am, am I audible?
Ji, please.
Ma'am, this thing came to my mind, that is breathing.
Ji.
Breathing is a activity of the body, but yet it is continuous. The moment it stops, the body ceases to exist. So I wanted some clarification on this.
Very nice, Seema ma'am. Very pertinent question. And especially this will come to the student's mind very quickly. Right?
So ma'am, there was one more question, but you deal with this, then I'll ask the other question.
Let us look at this breathing also. So when we look at this breathing is a collection of sub-activities. I breathe in and I breathe out. When I'm breathing in, I'm doing one set of the sub-activity, right? And then I'm breathing out. So the gap may be small, but the activity is not going on in continuity. So I can look at the activity more carefully and divide it into its sub-activities to see whether one activity is going on in continuity or not. Right? That is possible. So with that, I can help the student to see. Is it fine?
Yes, ma'am. Yes.
So this way we can help the student. The student can now explore within himself and he can see that, yes, even though we say that breathing is a continuous process, yet it is further subdivided into steps. Someone was mentioning about pumping of the blood. again, it comes with the jerk. The heartbeat is also a process which is subdivided. So the same activity is not continued throughout as far as the body is concerned. Right? And we can keep exploring within ourselves. Right now, when I'm talking, right, I'm not doing it in continuity. I'm taking pauses. Right? So there we can see any activity of the body will always be temporary or intermittent with some gaps. But whether I'm talking or not, I'm continuously thinking. These thoughts are running in me.
Mm-hmm. Right? That is part of the self?
Yes. So we can see that the activity of the self is going on in continuity, while the activity of the body is temporary, is intermittent, is with gaps. Just to see that the material entity is always temporary, while the conscious part is in continuation.
Mm-hmm. Okay, ma'am, that answers this query. There was one more query which I did not get an opportunity to voice, which was when we were defining the self and the body. The query was that as self, can we define, or where do these things come? Things like atma, ego, man, or emotion, guiding activities. Where do these come under self? Or this is a different thing altogether? I mean, atma or ego and all these things, are they different from the self? So this was when we were defining self and body, this was another question which came up.
So we can just see, I am not just body. Am I able to see this? What do you think?
Yes, I am a coexistence of both self and body.
So whatever is not material, all that put together is self.
Okay.
Right. So now I may refer to one part and give it a certain name.
Mm-hmm.
Right. So people have used various names. But right now, whatever is not material, all that put together is self. So it will include, mind will become a subpart of the self.
Mm-hmm.
Right. So all that will become subpart of the self itself, where self is everything which is not material in me.
Okay.
Right. So the material part is referring to the body, and the conscious part, which will include everything, is the self.
Everything. But ma'am, like ego is a negative version of the self then?
So I myself can be shady if I don't have that right understanding within me. Right. So if I don't have the clarity within me, I may have something which is going wrong in me. Some assumptions.
Okay.
Right.
Okay.
And that's what we are saying, that if we look at ourselves and we start ensuring this understanding part, right, I am able to refer to my own natural acceptance.
Okay.
Right. And ensure this harmony within me. Very nice.
Yes. Okay. Thank you, ma'am.
So all these questions, just like they are coming to us, they are definitely bound to come to our students, and they want answers. Right? Just see, when this little child is there in your own homes, you must have observed that the child keeps asking why, how, every now and then. So if some new person will come, this is a very common thing which a child will do. Who is he? So if you'll answer that one question, you say, where is he coming from? If you answer that question, why is he coming? What is he doing? And ultimately what happens is that after some 5-7 questions, we simply say, stop now. And now the child understands that now this is the limit. And now this person will have some kind of an indefinite behavior. And the child takes back. So this questioning is there within each one of us. But with time, what we are doing is we are somehow not allowing ourselves to question. We are grabbing the others also to question. But these questions have always been there within us. So when we start looking at these questions, which are there within us, and start seeking answers, that's where I'm ensuring this right understanding for myself. So now looking at ourselves from the point of view of this health. So as far as I look at the need of the self, this happiness is something which I need in continuity. And I and body coexist, and the need for the body is physical facility, which is to be ensured by the physiochemical things. Now, let us look at this whole feeling of self-regulation. When we say feeling of self-regulation, since it's a feeling, it is to be ensured in the self. Right? What do you think? Where is this feeling of self-regulation to be ensured? In the body or in the self?
Can we respond on the chat, please, participants?
Gee, so we are getting these responses on the chat that it is to be ensured in the self. Now let's look at what is this whole feeling of self-regulation. This feeling of responsibility towards the body. Right? Whatever I'm able to express is through the body. So I have this feeling of responsibility within me towards the body for nurturing it, for protecting it, and rightly utilizing it. And it is this feeling of self-regulation that is ensuring health for the body, where the body acts according to the self. For example, we can ask the students, look, you want to get up early in the morning at 5. And if you instruct the body and the body is able to do so, that means you are able to get up at 5 a.m. in the morning. What would you say? Is the body acting according to the self and are you ensuring health for the body or not? Yes or no? Right? But if you want to get up early in the morning, right? But every time the alarm rings, you close the alarm and you continue, even though you realize that getting up early is good for you. Now, in that condition, are we able to make the body act according to the self? Are we ensuring health for the body? Yes or no? We are getting so many no's. We are able to clearly see. So when we say health, this health is when the body acts according to the self and the parts of the body are in harmony. They work in order, right? And this is through this whole feeling of self-regulation. So let's take a quick reflection from you regarding this. What do you think about this proposal? While you're responding to this, maybe we would like to hear from Mrs. Selina ji. Can we have the reflection?
Selina Didi, you have the mic.
So the health problems today which we are facing, these health problems, what are they more due to? You can put your response. And Selina ji, if we can hear you, or maybe Dr. Ujwala Sandeep Dubey ji, you have the mic. Professor Deepali, if we are able to reach you, ma'am. Professor Deepali, Atish, Suryakant ji.
Hello, madam.
Ji, please, sir.
Yeah, madam. So as far as this question is concerned, I hope the today's problems are due to not body, due to because of self. Even I think psychologists are also says that is a majority of the diseases are because of psychological depression or thinking of the individual.
Very nice. Very nice, sir. You are able to see this for yourself. And for the student also, if we are able to facilitate with this, right, we are helping the student to look at himself more carefully. Very nice, sir.
Thank you, madam. Thank you.
Dipali ma'am, would you like to interact? We are unable to hear anything from you. Dipali ji? Okay, Dr. Nagamani ji, you have the mic with you.
The brain is a part of self or body?
Okay, Dipali ma'am is asking a very, very pertinent question with the students come up. So what do our participants think? Would anybody like to respond to this? Is brain a part of body or self? any one of our participants. Okay, Usha ma'am wants to say something. Dr. Usha Kumari ji, you have the mic. How would you like to respond to this question?
Yes, ma'am. Brain is part of body. Body only. That is actually coordinating all the activities in the body or passing information between self and body.
So we can facilitate the student that this brain is an organ within the body, and it is this brain which is enabling this communication.
Yeah.
That means the information in the form of sensations that come to the body are passed on to the self. That is done through the brain. So, very nice.
So, ma'am, it means brain is a part of cell.
No, the brain is part of body, Dipani ma'am, because it is an organ of the body.
Right? Okay. Thank you, ma'am.
Very nice. These are some pertinent questions which the students definitely come up with. And if we are able to help them in this exploration, it enables them to get clarity within themselves. So we can see over here the responses which we have get. So 65% people are clearly seeing that the health problems today are more due to the problem with the self. And another set says that it is with the problem with the body. So let's continue exploring within ourselves and facilitating our students also, right? So when we look at this whole body, the body is an orderly system. Right? To begin with, when we started as an infant, right, the body was 99.999% times, the body was in the form of absolute harmony, an orderly system, having a definite conduct. We see trillions and trillions of cells in the body working together in harmony with each other, participating in the larger order to form tissues, organs, organ systems, right? And it is my responsibility to ensure the continuity of this harmony, which I'm already blessed with to begin with. At least I should ensure that I don't disturb the harmony. Do you feel that responsibility within you? Yes or no? What do you think? Is it the responsibility of the self to maintain the continuity of this harmony in the body? So if you agree to this, we are getting so many yes. If I have a feeling of responsibility towards the body, which means I have this clarity that this body is my instrument, right? I'm able to express myself to the external world with this body. So I will do what is required to fulfill that responsibility. And once I take up that responsibility, a natural outcome is that health is ensured in the body. So the choice I'm making for the food, right? What do you think? Are we going to make right choices or not? Let us take up this reflection which is coming in front of us. So out of self-regulation and health, what holds a higher priority? Is it? Ji. Pratibha ma'am is very honestly putting that I really feel sorry each time I disturb the harmony out of my actions like sleeping late, eating untimely food and all that. Right? We all can see this exploration, this little exploration will enable our students to look within themselves. And that's what is the whole purpose. Right? While you are responding to this, let me take one quick Sanjay sir, Sanjay Kumar Pandeji, would you like to add something to this? Sanjay Pandeji? Okay, maybe.
No, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am. It was my mistake.
Okay. Dr. Tapas, would you like to mention something? Dr. Tapas ji?
Didi, Adelaide Didi has put a pertinent question on chat.
Okay. Who takes care of the body?
Ma'am, I'm audible.
Ji, please, sir.
Good afternoon, ma'am. Actually, you're absolutely right, ma'am. This is actually, we know the self-personal consciousness is very important. But sometimes, as a human being, always we try some experiment. And that actually really making us in problem. And that's why we are facing some problem in our health. ourselves, we know the fast food, junk foods are not good, but experimental purpose, sometimes we prefer because we have self-consciousness, junk food is bad, but still we are taking that. That's why we are making problem and we are making disorder to our system and disturbing the harmony of my actually.
Tapas, sir, let us ask this question to ourselves. Do I have information that junk food is bad for me or do I really know?
No, ma'am, actually, that I told. See, sir, ma'am, when basically we never prefer junk food, but sometimes when we are in the friend circle and we take that, that is actually to just for a relationship, okay. And that actually making problem. That is the biggest problem actually. Unless we know that the junk foods are not good, healthy foods are, home food is good, everything.
Tapas sir, once again, I'll repeat what I asked. I'm asking, do I have this information that junk food is bad? This intimation is there with me or do I really know what my body wants?
That information with us.
So when we say knowing, this knowing is to know the reality.
Yeah.
Right? That I and body are coexisting.
Yeah.
And I am the decision maker. The body is not making any decision.
Yeah, definitely.
Right? So yeah. If I am the decision maker, if I'm governed by some assumptions that my friends, what will they feel if I don't take this? Right? Have I verified these assumptions within me?
Yes, sir. Ma'am, sometimes we verify it. And what happens, suppose I means deny, no, I don't like these things. And so to just means make him at that instant to make him happy, actually we take that. Unless our intent is not to take that. But sometimes that happens. I'm telling sometimes it happens.
So we might be doing some errors, some mistakes in our life. But the moment I become aware, my frequency of doing the mistakes, will that
very less,
change
very
or
less,
not?
Sir. Definitely, ma'am. Very less. This is rare. It's rare, I'm telling you.
That's what we are saying, that with our students, if they become aware, they can change the frequency.
Yeah, definitely.
Right?
Yeah, thank you.
So that is going to add.
Right? Yes, ma'am.
Very nice, sir. Yes. Very nice. We all can see that with all this discussion, right, we are able to initiate this discussion so that they are able to check upon how often they are doing these mistakes for themselves. Do they really want to continue with these mistakes or do they want to work on themselves? Just like Adelaide ma'am also raised this question, who takes care of the body associated with the disturbed self? Whether the self is disturbed or in harmony, the decision is always by the self. But that decision, how right that decision is, will be decided by whether I am in state of harmony or I am not in state of harmony, or else whether I have ensured this knowing part or I am simply governed by assumptions. That is something which I can see. So I hope with this we can move further. So let us look at the whole program to ensure health for the body. Right? We can just see the results indicate that we are focused on having this self-regulation at a higher priority. Once we are able to ensure this self-regulation, health will be a natural outcome of this whole feeling of self-regulation. So the whole program to stay healthy, right, that starts from this whole intake and daily routine. When we say intake, it includes everything, air, water, sunlight, right? We all can discuss this with the students, that the food that we take, how should be that food? Should it be nutritious, digestible, tasty, and waste being excretable, or can we have any kind of food? And it includes all the intakes we are taking from our sense organs, right? So what will happen when we are taking something which is nutritious to the body, but we are simultaneously watching something violent? Are we taking the right intake? What do you think? So I'm sitting with a plate full of balanced diet, but I'm watching something violent so that my thoughts are fluctuating, right? So am I ensuring the right intake, right? My daily routine, time to get up, time to do various things, right? Am I including labor, exercise? We all can discuss this whole program to stay healthy, where we focus on all these various postures, yoga, pranayam, regulated breathing, so that the body organs work properly. Now, this is the priority, that I work on this particular program to ensure this health. And if there is some kind of a disharmony, some kind of a temporary disharmony with the body, then with the help of some local kitchen medicine or something to begin with, or other forms of medicines like we have Ayurveda and so many, right, we can try to bring body back from that temporary disharmony. And do we really want to depend on any kind of machines or drugs to really perform the body function or to undergo some kind of a treatment? That is something we have to see. What should be the priority for the students, right? We can just ask. This is what we are asking. We are posing these questions to the students so that they can themselves see what should be the priority order in which we need to execute this whole program to ensure health. So let us take your reflection quickly on this particular aspect. I can see that all the four programs are important for my health. What do you think? While you're putting your responses to this, we would like to hear from some of our participants regarding this. So, Mrs. Lakshmi Priya, would you like to interact?
Good afternoon, madam. Am I audible?
Yes, ma'am, please.
Ma'am, you told that by using the self-regulation process, we can minimize the diseases that occurring to our body. So my doubt is, suppose we are having some of the diseases that are genetic in nature, like blood pressure, then rheumatoid arthritis, then even if we are obeying, even if we are all the rule regulations that we are importing upon ourselves, at last also we are falling on this disease, we are suffering with these diseases, then how the self-regulation is useful in these cases? Please reply.
A similar question has been put by Vikas Jainkari ji also in the chat, where he's saying that how can we expect this, that some of the diseases like cancer and all, they are probably due to damaged cells which are part of the body. So how can we apply this self-regulation and all? A similar question which you were just asking. Okay. Now let's see. Most of the lifestyle disorders, what do you think? These lifestyle disorders, even if we talk about cancer or something, right? Let's look at the reasons why more and more people are acquiring these disorders, these diseases for themselves, right? If you look at this, we say that some 50, 70 years back, people had far more healthier life, right? Can we check out the levels of stress we are having, right? The kind of food we are having, the methodology which is used to grow that food, where we are using excessive fertilizers and so many other things, right? To ensure more and more profit, we are engaging in these practices. So we all need to look at it with a holistic perspective within ourselves, right? So I hope you have put your responses to this. And so many of us are saying that, yes, all the four programs are important for my health, right? If I'm unwell, definitely I'll take the medicines. I'll do what is needed. But I will also look at why am I healthy. Sumati ma'am is mentioning that in a very short duration, we are growing paddy. So we can just see what kind of methodology we are using to maximize our profits. Are we governed by this profit maximization throughout, neglecting our procedures, right? So this is something which we all need to collectively look into. So we may look at just one aspect of the problem. But now with all this together, let's look at the problem with the holistic vision. So when we say intake, this intake means that whatever is going into us via our sense organs, in the form of air, in the form of water, sunlight, food, thoughts, right? All that. So to maintain health, The food has to be nutritious, digestible, tasty, and it should be such that the waste is excretable. That means the food has to be fiber rich, right? Are we ensuring that by including more and more maida, fine flour in our diet? Are we able to ensure that the food we eat is rich in fiber? Simultaneous awareness of other intakes, such as what we are taking in from our sense organs. Right? When we are watching something or arguing with someone while eating, are we able to ensure the right kind of intake for ourselves? What do you think? Yes or no? Ji, Meena ma'am is mentioning that we need to take care of the environment also. Very true. Very true. We have to ensure this daily exposure to fresh air and sunlight. Right? Nowadays, we want to spend hours and hours in air condition. Are we doing it the right way? We can just see. There's so many things to look at. Now the student, we are putting it forth to the student for himself to decide, so that he can make a choice for himself. What does he want for himself? Do you want health for yourself? Can health be ensured without this feeling of self-regulation within? Right? So this is the circadian rhythm, right? Where our body is designed in accordance with this nature, the solar cycle, right? So if we look at our secretion of hormones, that secretion of hormones is specially designed in accordance with the solar cycle. So when we are able to wake up well before 6 p.m., that's around the sunrise, right? And we are able to follow this cycle at 12 p.m. when the sun is strongest. Our digestive juices are at the strongest, which means that that is the time when I can take the heaviest meal of the day, because my hormones at that point are activated in such a way. The sun is at the top and the digestive juices are secreted in such a way. So the preferable lunch time which I should have, right? By the time we move on to 2 p.m., 3 p.m., the body comes in this mode of assimilation and absorption, where the further processes of the body, they are taken care of, right? Further, as we move ahead, we can just see that by the time the sun is ready to set, our digestive juices are declining continuously. So anything we are taking at the later part of the day or later part of the evening, practically, we are not able to digest that properly. By the time it is 10, right, our body is looking for the hormones like serotonin, melatonin, the sleep hormones. Right? But they will only be there when the load on the digestive system is minimized. Right? So by the time, if we go to bed by 10, by 12, we are in a state of deep sleep. And once we are in this state of deep sleep, then only the liver activation takes place, where the detox and the repair mechanism is initiated in the body. So now, if someone is awake till 12, can that process be initiated thoroughly? Now, are we able to see all this in our own daily routine? Are we following the circadian rhythm? What do you think? Let's take up this question for you all and, of course, for the students. Do I follow the circadian rhythm? This is just an honest answer for each one of us to look at our own state, just to get acquaintance with what am I doing? Am I having this self-regulation within me? Meenakshi ma'am, would you like to interact? Mrs. Meenakshi Madhav Rao.
Yes, good afternoon, ma'am. Nowadays, there is a lot of exposure to the students through these electronic media. There are different YouTube videos are there, then WhatsApp chatting, Instagram, and they are getting a lot of information about the food and the health-related articles. So does it affect their health because of this exposure? This is my query.
So Meenakshi ma'am, can reading of those articles, will that help, or by realizing that the self-regulation is to be ensured in the cell? what is a better way? What do you think will lead to a holistic solution?
Yeah, self-regulation definitely that is there, but students, I don't think so. Ki, are they thinking in the right way? As a mentor, I think we need to take up this proposal in front of the students while teaching the health issues. Ki, whatever is given in the YouTube videos or the on the media, that is everything is not correct. You have to verify at your own level and according to your health or body.
Very true. When we are able to discuss these proposals with the student is able to explore for himself and see what is right for him, how he can ensure this health. So that is really nice for each one of us. So we can just see that some are saying that most of the times they are following the circadian rhythm. Some are saying only sometimes. Some are honestly saying that never. And some are saying that I do it always. So this is something which we can have a look at for ourselves. Very nice. Very nice. Okay. So when we say labor or exercise, this labor is when we are ensuring adequate movement of the body so that there is this some kind of physical labor is involved to produce something. Like if we are involved in some kind of agricultural practices, we are definitely doing some labor. But for a student, what kind of labor we can suggest is that they can take care of their own rooms, right? They can sweep the floors. They can work in the kitchen garden associated to the mess. They can cycle to the college and come back. And with all that, they are ensuring labor. And if labor is not possible for them, at least some kind of an exercise where they are taking adequate movement of the body, regulating postures for internal and external body organs in the form of yoga and pranayama. After this, still, if there is some kind of a temporary disharmony, right, these home remedies, integrated systems of medicine and all, that can be, to begin with, utilized. And at a later stage, would we really like to go for some kind of a treatment, some kind of dependence on drug and machine to perform a body function? So the priority, are you able to see that the priority to ensure health, the whole program to ensure health is as suggested, or do you find that there has to be some other priority? What do you think? Is the priority correct? Let us take your reflection on this. Are you able to see? So, taking your reflection. So, what is my take on the priority for program for health? Can you see this? Now, while you're putting your priority, let me take one reflection from Pooja ji. Would you like to interact? Or Professor Ranganath ji, would you like to interact?
Yes, madam.
Ji, sir.
I take priority, madam, to keep my health. Yes. And in order to keep myself healthy, I do go for doing some exercise, taking qualitative food, madam. Yes. And I work, madam. Work makes me very healthy. And I'll be free from tense or stress. That is what I do daily, madam. I give priority to work, madam, which makes me very happy and peaceful, madam.
Nice, sir.
Nice, sir.
Very nice. So,
Thank you, madam.
Nice. We can just see with all this discussion, the students come up and are able to set priority for themselves, where they can prioritize the way in which they want to continue this harmony of the body, right? Because they're using this body throughout. So we can just see the response which you have put for the poll. And so many of us are saying that they do agree or strongly agree that the priority which is being set over here, that priority is in the correct order. So very nice that we all have been able to explore it for ourselves. When we look at our own present state, with so many assumptions going on within us, right? The present state, while we are making some kind of a selection of food, what am I doing? Right? We can discuss this with the student. What kind of food, right? When you decide that let's go and have dinner, what is the priority? Are you selecting the place based on how you can have attention from the others, which means governed by your own preconditionings, that if I will go and sit at so-and-so place, I'll ensure respect for myself? Or based on your sensation, you're looking at some kind of a spicy food, some kind of a fancy food, based on your sensation? Or with this clarity that the food is needed to nurture the body, with this whole feeling of self-regulation, you are able to make a choice, or you are making some kind of a selection for food. So we have to see, how are we making our choices? So with all this discussion regarding health, we can ask these questions to our students, right? That if we assume human being equals to body, then we are trying to seek happiness through sensations from the body or getting right feelings from the other. And as a result of this, somehow we are harming the body due to excessive consumption or overindulgence to get the favorable sensation. Some kind of overeating, consumption of junk food, right? That is something which is very common we see around. We are also somehow trapped with this. A large number of diseases which are psychosomatic in nature, we are able to see this. Now, the continuity of happiness cannot be ensured by feelings from the others. Most of our complaints, right? The students, he is not talking to me nicely, so I'm in depression, so I'm eating more, right? All these issues keep coming. So with all this clarity, what is the holistic solution to address to these issues, right? We'll take up one quick response from, okay, maybe Lopa Mudra ji, would you like to interact? What would be your suggestion, holistic solution to address these issues with this, which the students are commonly facing? As a student, what would you like to respond? You are unmuted, Lopa Mudra ji, but we are unable to hear you. Okay, Dr. Chetan, would you like to interact and respond to this, Dr. Chetan? So with all this discussion, the key issue that we have tried to touch upon is to enable the students to get this definition of self-regulation. So in the session, if we are able to communicate this to our students, what is the meaning of health? To understand this prosperity, looking at the whole program for self-regulation, with the help of examples, if we are able to illustrate it to our class, right? Let's have a look, very quick look at some of the frequently asked questions, right? And let's take quick responses from you. So if you have to choose between health and happiness, what should you choose? Let's see what responses come from you. Right, so some are saying health, some are saying happiness. Okay, let's go to the proposal. Happiness is to be in harmony. Harmony within, that is harmony at the level of individual. Now within that harmony, this feeling of self-regulation is included. And with that feeling of self-regulation, I can ensure health for myself. So when I have this clarity within me, I'm able to work for both. They will run along with each other. There's no contradiction. That is something which I can see. So with all this discussion, let us quickly look at the quiz now with all the discussion we had in this current session regarding